Come and talk to me, oh baby. I really wanna meet you. Can I talk to you? I'm happy you're back.
I'm back.
Welcome
Better
back.
Better than ever.
Welcome back to the J-Lowdown. We're here with episode 2, holiday edition. We're getting into Turkey Day. Then we'll have Valentine's Day. But Autumn's single, so we might not actually do a Valentine's Day.
Who's single?
According to you before we shot this, you.
Oh, yeah. Ooh. Well, he did just FaceTime.
First of all, it is 2. It is 2 o'clock in the afternoon.
First of all, he broke up with me and then also FaceTimed me like 3 times after that. So
right.
What does that mean?
She goes, it's 2 o'clock in the afternoon here, East Coast time, and this guy is also on the East Coast. And she's like, well, have a good night.
Good night.
Good night.
It's been great talking to you.
It's been great talking to you.
I'm busy.
No, but we're stoked. We're going to be talking Thanksgiving. That's going to be our main topic. We've also got some other lit things and hit things.
Yes.
Things that I'm over, things that I'm into. We're going to be getting into all of it.
We also have a special topic of discussion for the end of the show.
Yes.
I know y'all have been waiting for us to discuss.
You've been waiting for us to talk about this for a while, and we will finally be talking about it because it needs to be talked about. And apparently everybody doesn't watch Love & Hip Hop, but I know if you saw those women that I showed you last month, you definitely Googled it. So you're welcome, Mona Scott. You're welcome, Mona Scott, for the extra check. Halloween just happened, so congratulations if you were culturally appropriating.
Ah,
we see you. We see you, all the white people in those Native American headdresses.
What was your Halloween about?
My Halloween, what did we do? We did Huey, Dewey, and Louie.
Yes,
we did.
I was Louie or...
Which is cultural appropriation because we don't know what it's like to be ducks. We're speciesists.
I thought about that later
on. Yeah, it was wrong.
I was walking around like, quack, quack.
Right, yeah.
They spoke English.
Right,
so
I don't think...
racist. Well, I was Whitney Houston. No drug references.
Okay, perfect.
So I think I did great.
That is great. Well, you respected the memory.
Because I love her. You know that.
Yes. All right, guys. Let's get into the lit list.
Lit list.
Come on, let's do it.
Lit list.
Next.
Lit list.
Next.
I'm so fucking grateful for my list.
Everybody can identify with the context of this song. You know, you're grateful, you're happy, you're ready to move on. I personally feel like I'm on to my next, which is very kind of cool in a weird little way.
I'm grateful for all my exes because they still always check in on every holiday they can.
Right.
They like saving time.
Right. That
so
is.
Yes. Thank you for always checking on.
That's also. I feel like that's a great Thanksgiving lit list.
Thank you. Next.
Moving on. What else is lit? Lit. This Thanksgiving is these Thanksgiving
clapbacks.
I'm here for a Thanksgiving clapback every single time. Every time I see you, you got a different hair color. Every time I see you, you got a different man.
Oh.
Aunt. Auntie.
Oh.
All right.
Oh.
You keeping them grades up? You keeping up your parole? You keeping up with your probation officer? Thanksgiving.
Clap.
Clap.
Bad.
Man, I ain't seen you in a while. And I'm like, but you ain't seen your baby daddy in about 5 to 10, though, right?
Oh. Blue. Clap.
Bad. I'm sorry.
But you know who has the best clapbacks, and I'm so happy that this is back. Real Housewives.
My girl Mimi is back. We can't talk about lit without talking about Housewives. Give me my peach. Give me my peach. If Autumn and I were housewives, we would have solo cups, and it would be the Real Housewives of Jersey City. What would your housewives tagline be?
My tagline would be, mind your business. And scene.
My tagline would probably be something like corny and punny. It would be like, where there's a will, there's a J.
Okay, dad joke. Okay, right, J, right, senior. J out of my way. I'm here to J.
This is a 1J street.
But I'm so excited.
You might have seen me catwalk, but have you seen me jaywalk? As Wendy Williams said, we do a cheap show here. But it is always nice to see on cheap TV something that is priceless. So we thank Atlanta for that. Speaking of priceless, Portia, I see you taking your man to get engagement rings at the same place that you took your husband. It's tacky.
No, it's not.
It's tacky.
If she knows she likes the jewelry there, then that's where I'm going to go get my jewelry.
There are other jewelers. You're going
to say, oh, me and my husband shopped at Saks, so we're not going back to Saks.
Yes. That's different. It's a private jeweler. We're not talking about like a general, like that's not like, oh, I got my ring at Macy's.
Portia, it's fine.
I disagree, Portia. I disagree.
Also, those new titties.
Those new titties. Girl, the new titties and the new bun in the oven. Like, you're, like, clearly pregnant in episode one. Like, she's clearly, like, a day pregnant already when they started filming. But, like, whatever. We'll see how this plays out. Happy for you and your baby or whatever.
I'm excited for her. And to find out what tea that they know about her.
Well, I need to know what Candy knows.
Everything.
Candy knows.
She's not even going to tell us everything.
She knows. Oh,
Candy,
not.
I love you.
Candy's not going to tell us everything at the until the reunion, and then it's not even all going
to
spill.
And it's because she's going to be forced. So they need to force her hand.
They need to change Candy's name to Kettle, because that bitch holds tea. That's what they need to
do. She gets a little whistle, but she don't
let the whole teapot out, and it's good.
I'm so excited for this season, though. I know it's going to be a lot of good moments.
Yeah, it's going to be good, but I think...
And Sheree came out with her joggers.
Sheree, you don't get to be on the hit list or the lit list this week, because, first of all, I can't get the joggers. I saw the 404 error. That was a month ago. Here, let's check now. No, in real time. In real time. We'll check right now. This is real. I'll make sure that
the joggers are sold out.
The site's not even up, She by Sheree. So have fun in Neverland in your joggers, because I can't.
Another clap back.
I'm so over you, Sheree. Like, stop. You know good and goddamn well your wigs are out of control, and whoever your gay is well.
That's it for another show.
Just rock the braids. I could do a whole show, Sheree, about your wigs. But yes, Atlanta is lit. Tonight we're going to be talking about some Thanksgiving stuff, because mm-hmm. we are in that month. It is time to get fat and sleepy. Men and women of Thanksgiving.
The indigenous people, the Native Americans,
yes,
we love
Native
you.
Native Americans, we
and
love
this
you.
This day is about you.
It's not a...
And these lit foods.
We can't get into the logistics of how this all went down. The food is delicious, and that's what we're going to talk about today. So, my favorite Thanksgiving food has to be my mom's candied yams. And candied yams at Thanksgiving are the one time that you get to throw a dessert in at dinner time.
I'm surprised by that.
Maple syrup, little marshmallow fluff, maybe like 4 yams, but mostly just marshmallow fluff and maple syrup. Bake, serve. Oh, it's so good. Mom, I haven't had her yams in a minute. She lives in LA now, but like, her yams were so good.
Ask her to send you a recipe.
My mom's a white lady.
Yeah, I knew by the marshmallow fluff, so you didn't have to say that.
And ranch dressing. No. A little ranch.
She's not that white. She's still Italian. Don't disrespect her.
That's
like that.
True.
But my favorite of all favorites, which I'm shocked you didn't say this, mac and cheese. Macaroni with, no, actually, it just be cheese with a little bit of mac added.
Right.
That's how I like it.
Yeah. So Thanksgiving is one of those times where anything that you eat in normal times is then all of a sudden in its pokey evolution. So it's like you have not a Charmander mac and cheese, you have a Charizard mac and cheese. And that means brown crust.
Fully evolved.
That means pasta noodles.
4 cheeses.
That means 4 cheeses. Black people don't really baste turkeys, it's like a lot of adobo.
No,
you
know what I mean? No. That's how we can tell you did grow with a black grandma. That
I had, she's
good. Because we basted turkeys.
Yeah, I've
we
never.
We getting all that juice out, we getting all butter. Adobo. A buttery base. Maybe a little lemon pepper. You know, black people love a little lemon pepper on something.
So we're talking lit Thanksgiving foods, and we were talking about mac and cheese for a minute. Now we're getting into our dessert category. I live for an apple pie. I live for a like a pound cake moment. I don't like ice cream. Pie. Yeah, I don't like ice cream at Thanksgiving unless it's in tandem with pie. Like, don't serve me ice cream that's not a dessert. Like, that's bought. That's not dessert.
It has to go a la mode with something.
Right, with something. You have to serve ice cream with something.
That's just for the kiddie table, just a scoop of ice cream.
From desserts, we're gonna get right into it right now. The hit list, which are things that I personally think need to be hit off this market. It's like Kill Bill stuff. It's not like hit list, like, no, that's what I call hits. It's like, no, hit list, Kill Bill, like, we're done.
Dead.
Like, I'm done with these things. Is cranberry sauce a dessert or is it a side dish?
It doesn't matter what it is. It needs to be gone.
Done.
It needs to be over.
Stop.
I don't care if you make it from scratch. I don't care if it's out the can.
If it's from scratch, it's something different. If it's from scratch, it's something different. That's like a marmalade or like a jam or something. It's something that goes on cornbread. It is not to be eaten by itself. Also, stop serving it in the can. I know there are people out there that love the way that tastes. It's gross. Stop. Y'all know what you're doing. It's horse hoof cranberry.
After you smoke a little,
horse hoof cranberry. No. The only time cranberry sauce is good is if you're doing, like, you know that leftover Thanksgiving sandwich?
With this, yeah.
So if you're doing, like, bread, turkey, potatoes, gravy, cranberry sauce, another slice of bread. There's this whole, like, fall soup thing happening.
Autumnal soup.
Yeah, I don't know if it's because, like, we're on the East Coast, it's a little brisk, we want something, like, warm,
they want to drink their meal.
They want to sip. I'm not doing that at Thanksgiving. I need to chew.
Apple pumpkin spiced soup.
Yeah. No one wants to sip a beverage for a side dish. Like, that's not a thing. Stop serving me things in gourds creatively. I've had it. It's enough. I don't need to sip squash soup out of a squash. You know what I need? I need mashed potatoes.
Stop serving me.
That's what I need.
Virgin Bloody Mary mix.
Just make a salad. Like, why are you being creative? Why are you reinventing stuff? Also, in terms of reinventing stuff and things that are on the hit list for Thanksgiving, stop putting nuts into
things.
Nuts are not for people. Nuts are for birds. Birds eat nuts.
Yes.
Trail mix is not for people.
I personally hate nuts.
And you can always see the people who eat nuts because they eat nuts like a tiny person or a rodent.
No, no.
Everybody who eats nuts looks like this. This is all what you look like. Some creature from somewhere. Hey, why are there almonds in my stuffing? Is this a bar? Are we at a bar? Right, but with nut allergies today, you just can't be too careful either. It's a liability and a risk, and y'all are putting everybody in danger.
Yeah.
Stop.
For group meals, it's best just to leave all the nuts at home.
What else don't you like for Thanksgiving?
Food-wise, why are we still serving parts of the pig that were meant?
She's talking about chitlins. They don't make chitlins on my black side. They don't do ham hocks.
My family also doesn't do that.
They don't do oxtails. I've never experienced any of these things. And I wouldn't eat them.
Oxtails are banging.
So stop putting nuts into things. Stop making things happen that don't need to happen. I don't need to eat soup on Thanksgiving.
Soup is never gonna happen.
Anything that needs to be held in a Tupperware is not to be served at Thanksgiving. That means any kind of casserole, not the time. But I just need to move on. I need to move on because it's like, not only are you giving me empty calories and wasting my time and my taste buds, you've insulted everybody at the table. It's like you don't love your family. It's rude.
You know, we like to call things bakes instead of casseroles.
Ugh.
A little bake.
Listen, a meatloaf is a meatloaf, and that's just
a little
what
meat
it is.
Bake.
Ugh. You know when you go, I hate when you go to somebody's house for Thanksgiving, I just need to stop by my friends, and like they have like hot dogs, or like they want to do like a Thanksgiving remix. Oh, we're just doing pizza, we decided to keep it low key this year.
Okay,
yeah, why don't you take your shame and go sit in a room? Or like Stouffer's, dude, try. It's so easy. You can hungry man Thanksgiving if you really want to. Like, you don't need to be out here doing stuff that's nonsense. As a hair professional, We come into a busy season. It is usually September until Christmas, and it is usually very crazy. Around this time of year, Vogue.com, Finery29, some blogger will decide to coin a hair phrase that is for a hair color that makes no sense. And so this is my personal hit list today. This is at the top. I want my clients and people specifically to stop reading articles in magazines and then asking hairstylists to understand what that means. Because you cannot sit down in my chair and be like, so...
Hey, can I get a mushroom brown?
That's a thing. That's a thing. That's on a website right now. You can Google mushroom brown hair. It is highlighting somebody's hair and then making it dirty blonde.
Just show a picture.
Right. Stop with the same. I'm not doing tiger's eye blonde hair. I'm not doing fortune teller hair. I'm not doing troll doll bush hair. Don't know if you want no My Little Pony hair. I'm over the trend. Cream soda blonde.
Because we need another name.
Why? Girls can't pronounce balayage. And balayage is spelled like balayage. So I have girls coming in asking me for a cream soda balayage. You've made the problem so much worse in terms of communication.
I'm just gonna sip.
Editors, you're not hairstylists. You don't understand color theory. You barely know what you're looking at. Or, can I have rose gold hair? Sure, you can have rose gold hair. How do you want rose gold hair?
Become a watch.
Like, I can't. There's so many variations into everything. And also, when you're coming in for an appointment, what you booked may not be what you actually want. So, like, acknowledge that.
It might look terrible on you, is what he's trying to say. Facts. You might look really ugly with facts. What you're asking
also,
for.
Also, like, if you want to do a whole hair change, buy a lace front. Speaking of lace fronts, this brings us to our final portion of the hit list. Autumn and I agreed that this would be something that we've talked about a lot, and
I feel bad about this being on the hit list, but it's necessary.
It was a hard pill to swallow. We tried to avoid it for as long as we could. But we have to talk about it. Anika Mirage, this goes out to us. We were long-standing fans of you, but you are closing out. You've liked a Nicki Minaj.
Super bass. But Monster? Right. Monster is one of the best female verses on a song ever.
You've had your moments with her. I am more of a pop guy, so she is more in my wheelhouse these days, which is weird considering that she's a rapper. But you're closing out our hit list, babe. And it's because...
You're rude.
Yeah, you're rude. You're rude, you're entitled, you're annoying. Titled.
What?
Entitled.
What really gets me going, though, about Nicki is that no one that has achieved what she achieved, and I'm not trying to take anything away from her, you know, she's very successful in her career.
We actually can't take anything away from her. We do this show from my apartment. We don't have the power.
I like to give props where it's due, but I must also say, ever since she disrespected my girl Mariah on American Idol, that's when I've been feeling some type of way about her.
Autumn and I remember that you did a song with Mariah Carey. It's called Up Out My Face.
Up Out My Face.
It's about to pop up right now, and y'all there's a Barbie screen. Dolls. Right, y'all were Barbie dolls, and it was all cute, cute, and geeky, and then all of a sudden on American Idol, y'all want to act brand new. You're both rude because you don't listen.
Not you, Mariah.
No, Mariah, you're rude, but I'm here. I'm here for your rudeness, Mariah. I'm not here
because
for
because you're a legend. Yeah, she's been a legend for the past 10 years.
Also, you're my like mixed goddess. You basically run all of us mixed people. It's her and Halle Berry. Those are the people that we all look up to. Sorry,
she
Alicia
can
Keys.
Earn her
you
rudeness.
Can run all you want, Alicia Keys. You listen. I think
no. Listen, another show.
It's a
another
show
with Alicia Keys and her charity music.
I don't have time for Alicia Keys to get into mixed stuff with Alicia Keys.
Can we talk about the Nicki and Cardi beef and how I love Cardi and I just want to say I definitely stand her. So
I feel like this is a very good way to bundle up the show because we are talking about Thanksgiving and I am so thankful for Cardi B. So thankful. Zona, I'm so thankful Cardi B. Zona, backing it up. Like, she she's our inner monologue. I feel like she's like the spokesperson of the people. I was here for every one of her Instagram rants. I believe everything that she said. Even if what she's saying is a lie, Nicki, you just come across as more of a liar. That ass, lie. That hair, lie.
To be fair, Cardi's booty fake too, and her titties are fake.
Cardi's lies appear to be real. And Nicki's are just, we see right through you, girl.
My pet peeve, not even a pet peeve. I hate when people try to do a whole victimizing thing. Nicki tries to act like she is a victim in every situation.
She's been a victim when since really, that whole
she
Wayne
trashes
rant.
People. She yeah, trashes she's people nonstop. Disrespectful. How can you think you can have a segment on your whole show? Her of the day.
Oh, the of the day.
How can you think you can have a segment like that where you talk about people?
I'm kidding. I'm sorry, babe. You're not
like that, and you don't think anyone is gonna come for you. You're not a likable person.
That's the thing, like, you used to be funny, and you used to have, like, there was always, like, a little bit of honey with her spice, and now it's just, like, it's just really apparent that you seem to have fallen off. Like, just because a new Supreme has risen does not mean that you're going to die.
And we remember how she treated Kim. Let's never forget.
Also, like, we know that at this point that you love a beef to make you relevant, and it hasn't been about the music for you in a very long time.
I believe, like, deep down inside, you know, once you start popping out in Percocets, you really start to get in your emotions.
Well, I hate to say this about her, but she is, in fact, an actress. She is just like me. We went to a performing arts high school.
The drama.
Yeah, and so it is. It's just very much that. And she has to have some accountability in that. But the fact that you're out here acting all hard and tough, you're not hard and tough. Like, you're.
Because how you going to talk about one show how black women need to carry themselves better because Cardi was about to beat that ass?
The bottom line is,
the next moment you was talking about guns and pulling up on people.
She's
I'm
on
confused.
Twitter. I don't know any of that.
Yes, I am all about. She's on all
Twitter.
About
follow her Twitter.
Like Chun-Li, you know what I mean? You
right. You,
you
a street fighter. You street
right.
fighter.
You,
right? And you've been,
you been
on.
You've been on.
You've been on. But if you've been on, why are you checking some new girl?
She shouldn't be beneath you, which Cardi isn't because. The level of success that she has, you shouldn't be taking that away from her either. You should let her live in that.
Just
let her be her. You know what I mean?
Also, you were for it when she was on Love and Hip Hop. She was all for it. She was all for
until
it.
Until she became a
Until it was a
threat.
Thing. Until it was a thing. Now it's a thing and now everybody's embarrassed and upset. Honestly, the best chick who had the best idea was Wendy Williams. About Remy, MC Lyte, Nicki, Kim, Cardi.
Ladies Night Remix.
Ladies Night Remix. Charity concert. Missy Elliott MCs.
Yes.
We will buy tickets. We will buy a whole row. That would be so lit. Like, let's do some, like, women empowerment shit. Like, let's get some Spice Girl shit back in
and
this
mix. And
even
if we don't want to do that, let's just, I mean, I'm all down with beef when it comes to rap shit.
No, this is beef and broccoli. Is what
I'm all about.
It's not
that.
Straight beef. I need beef patty. I need
I'm
burger.
With that.
I need burger.
That beef, and broccoli.
Beef and broccoli is what Nicki and Cardi are doing. It's not true beef. Foxy Brown and Lil' Kim.
Because
that's
Lil' Kim, everyone forgets that Lil' Kim
that's
went to jail.
Hamburger.
Okay.
Hamburger.
Y'all young kids
Trina.
Don't know.
Trina. Hamburger. Trina. Hamburger. And Trina's
Quarter
on,
pounder.
Trina's on songs with mad but there are several that she does not. And that is beef. This whole Nicki Minaj, Cardi B thing, this is beef and broccoli. This is some sweet and sour National Enquirer, Us Weekly type shit. It's not hip hop. Y'all either need to square up or do a lie detector test on Mari.
No,
I'm not having it.
Cardi tried. Cardi is trying to eat a quarter pounder and Nicki is trying to have a beef flavored ramen.
Right, on top of white rice.
That's she went along media beef. Cardi want that real smoke.
Like you and I are on that Baconator shit.
We are
on that Q, on that QB, that
right.
That Q pounder.
I'm on a flank steak.
I'm on that medium rare.
T-bone.
Not that mystery beef and broccoli.
It's supposedly over now, right?
Well, now it's all good vibes.
Okay,
until,
we'll see who's gonna be the petty one
until,
first.
Until next J-Lo down when we find out in a month who is happening. Oh my god, this was so fun.
So much fun.
So fun. I cannot wait until next month to do this with you guys again. Thank you guys all for watching. And with that, I think that is this month's J-Lo Down.
With that, we can say
thank you.
Next.
Thank you.
Next.
No, we had fun today. Definitely follow me on Instagram. I'm Infamous J Jackson. You can go to Facebook and like J. Scott Jackson Jr. And Autumn is
at True Religion. Also follow my accessory jewelry page at goddess.crown. Don't forget the dot, because if you do, I'm going to go off. Thank you, guys. Love you. Next
Thank
episode.
Thank you. Yes,
we'll
subscribe.
See you
we'll
month.
See you next
Before
month.
Before Christmas.
Yes, with the snow.
I won't see you next month.